filling you out here for the Lingus News. I'm here with Cat Ramsey, the man who discovered Amanda Berry. Mr. Ramsey.
You can call me Cat.
All right, Cat.
But you can still call me Mr., though.
Okay, Mr. Cat. Tell me what happened.
Well, see, I heard a scream, right? And I was eating my Taco Bells, and it wasn't that good. And I was kind of pissed off that there was enough cheese and everything. I always like a lot of extra cheese. That's what I asked for, you know? But these pizza gringos always fuck my shit up, you know? And that's another thing, you know? Why are these pizza gringos working at them, you know, always taking jobs from Mexicans, you know what I'm saying?
Cat, can you just tell me what happened next?
Well, I put my cool red Dorito tacos down, and that wasn't easy, you know what I'm saying? So I go outside, and I see this Ruka trying to get out the house, and she says, help me get out, I've been here for long times. I'm like, bitch, and I've been in this situation before, you know, where Ruka tries to leave my house, saying I put hands on her, and then try to holler rapes, you know, just kind of get a piece of the cat's kingdom, you know what I'm saying? Like, the world is mine and everything, you know? But the only time I put hands on Ruka is when they got some big-ass knockers.
Mr. Cat, can we stay on topic, please?
Well, see, what I was just going to do was just going to walk away, you know? It's not my business, you know what I mean? But then there was some neighbors outside, and there's this one Ruka that I've been trying to get at for years, for a long time, you know what I'm saying? So I figured, I'm gonna go over there and like fucking follow, kick the door down like a G, like I'm the biggest boss around, you know what I'm saying?
So what are you saying? You did this out of the goodness of your heart?
Nah, bitch, I did that shit for pussy, and sometimes that shit works.
So what happened next?
So this girl gonna tell me her name is Amanda Berry, and I'm like, but you say that like that means something to me or something.
That name didn't ring a bell?
Not at first, until I was on the phone with 911, and I said, you know, I got this girl who wants me to call you guys, and her name's Amanda Berry. I'm like, oh, shit. And I thought this was that Ruka from back in the day, where I, you know, didn't put a rubber on, so I thought, you know, she had a kid with her. So I thought she was trying to give me for some pregnancy test or maternity. I was like, fuck Maury Povich and shit. You know, so I turned her and I started choking the Ruka.
Well, you started choking her?
I mean, I was choked up by her, you know what I'm saying? So she was, you know, kidnapped by this neighbor and everything.
So, did you know this neighbor very well?
Oh yeah, we used to kick it all the time, you know, from eating enchiladas, quesadillas, empanadas, you know, all that stuff. That's just to name a few, you know what I'm saying? I mean, I'm telling you, this guy's come over, I mean, this guy must have some big levels to do something like that. I see that pig every day.
And what was her reaction when she got up?
I knew something was up when a pretty white girl just ran into a cholo's arm. That's a dead giveaway. Dead giveaway.
Thank you very much, Cat.
That's a dead giveaway. I mean, either way, she was running to serve me papers or to me to some paternity test. That's the only way pretty white girls are running to Mexicans' arms, you know what I'm saying?
All right, thanks, Cat.
Jesus Christ, this guy can't even make it in time for the meat twitcher? What the fuck? All right, hey, it's the Wrestlingus Show. This is the Meat Twitcher board, and while we're waiting for Fausty Late Nuts, here's your Meat Twitcher. Jesus Christ. I just got a video text message from Mr. Fausty Walnuts, and I can't even explain this one, so just watch this.
Hey, sorry man, I couldn't make this week's show. I'm in Vegas, hanging out with my man Pac.
West Side.
He ain't dead, he's right here in Vegas. I might not leave either. I'll see you next time.
West Side. Go.
Alright then, let's get back to business. Congratulations to Velvet Sky, this week winning our Meat Twitcher. I know a lot of people would think AJ did for the whole ass slapping thing, but believe me, I'll be showing that later in the show as well. So, let's go. I gotta do cap off by myself.
Whatever.
So, Velvet, congratulations. She's at 7. She is 3 behind AJ, so how are we going to do this show this week? Fuck the desk. I got an idea. You ever seen this YouTube show? It's called the Philip DeFranco Show. He has a format that might work for this. So, Phil, you have a great show, but I'm about to rip you off and do the same exact show you do, but with wrestling. So, here we go. What's up, Lingus Mafia? I'm Cav Manning, and I'm Faustless. Apparently, Faust is still over in Vegas with the dead Tupac. Let's start this off right. I wish he was here, but what can you do? The show's got to go on, so we're going to try to do this a little bit different. It's show number 51. One more show, and we've done a full year of this nonsense. So you're going to see a lot coming in the next 2 weeks. In 2 weeks, we're going to have a crazy show that brings all the people back who've been on the show that were noteworthy. So it is May the 21st, 2013, and we're going to start off with TNA this week. A lot of nonsense and nothing too great happened on that show. It is really like pulling teeth trying to watch them, but anyway, we'll still go over what happened. AJ Styles, who is now the Sting, presently that was Sting back in the 2000s when he was the Crow hanging from the rafters, and he's brooding and dark now and everything. Sting's now trying to talk to him, saying, I know what it's like to go through this and yada yada. And then Angle comes in and ruins everything, as you can see, and it gets in a big clusterfuck. My favorite part of TNA actually this week was what I mentioned over in the Meat Twitcher segment, was that Velvet was walking to the ring in blue, and all of a sudden she came out and she was in pink. You know, it's the little details that work, that sell things better than others, so good job, TNA. How about this? We're going to have a tag team three-way. We know about three-ways here at the Lingus Show. Chavo Guerrero and Hernandez, Christopher Daniels and Kazarian, Storm and a partner of his choosing. It would be kind of cool to see America's Most Wanted get back together, which probably won't happen because old Chris Harris seems to be the laughingstock and a lot of jokes now about him with his character formerly in WWE. It'll probably be something lame that's just some guy sitting in the back and, you know, whatever. So now later we're back to this part where Joseph Park freaks out when he sees his own blood. And somehow he acts a little bit like Abyss. Imagine that, right? Here's my off-the-wall theory. I'm thinking he's a schizo. And he doesn't know he's really Abyss. And he freaks out and becomes this character back and forth. So I don't know how else they're going to do anything with this guy. When he comes out there with a mask, he's got the hair sewn onto the mask in the first place. So what's he going to do about it? He's coming out there clean shaven, just removes his teeth and shows his tattoos, and he's Abyss all of a sudden. I think Park's actually a more fun character to watch than it is to watch Abyss in the first place. And how do they end this show this week? Well, it is Bully Ray and Sting face to face. Sting's still wearing a t-shirt. Bully Ray, he says, if you don't win, you'll never get another title match ever. That's my stipulation. Hogan comes out crying and screaming, you don't have to do this, you don't have to do this. Sting agrees to it, gives up his whole future of title shots anyway if he doesn't win this or not. He doesn't need to take this match with the stipulations. It makes no sense. He won a match to get this match. So, why are you taking the stipulations? It makes no sense, TNA. On to the WWE. Last weekend was Extreme Rules. This pay-per-view was still better than WrestleMania. Shh. Cena and Ryback got into it at Extreme Rules and nobody won. That's why the match was not the main event, if you notice that. When you see them going ahead first, they're not going to send the fans home pissed off in the first place. Now, Ryback shows up on Raw in an ambulance. Call me crazy, but I actually thought Ryback was pretty decent on mic this week. Hey, I heard that. Fast forward on Raw, we had Wade Barrett and Fandango team up. Fandango, he was dancing outside the ring and wouldn't stop playing around while Barrett was getting pissed. So I guess this leads us to Fandango being the IC champ. Paul Heyman, he's going to bring out his new guy. Everyone's a buzz. Everyone's going crazy. Is it going to be RVD, which everyone starts screaming about? I didn't think RVD would be a good fit with him as a bad guy. I refuse to say that. Heel babyface bullshit. I don't conform to this nonsense. Another question was, could it have been Ryback? A good mouthpiece for him. He's always good with a monster. But then the suspense breaks and all of a sudden we get Kurt Axel. You know, I've learned a long time ago not to really question what Vince is doing. Never question much about what Vince chooses, other than, you know, we've seen a couple shit bombs, but you gotta let it ride, see what happens. So Triple H comes out to spoil the new debut. I love when they say debut and the guy's been here how long and been away and back and forth. Big E Langston beats the number one contender for the World Heavyweight Championship? My only thought about this would be that they're going to force Big E in a three-way with Ziggler and Del Rio. Flip him out, maybe he'll become a good guy or something. I still think he's the guy who's behind the Caitlyn text in the first place, so maybe we get some Jungle Fever? That match then leads into the AJ Layla match, which everyone loved to see. And this was an honorable mention for Meat Twitcher because Layla not only smacked the ass for a tap out, but she also gave it a good squeeze a couple times too, which I wouldn't mind being in that move.
Where can we sign up for that in the first place?
And I am to remind you, AJ's the only diva or knockout that doesn't wear pantyhose. It's a changing of the guard. They keep saying now it's the Shield's yard, not the Undertaker's anymore. This is a way to make Undertaker, I guess, go on his little vacation that he needed. They need a little star power, so they kept him for a little bit, but now it's back to normal. Normal for us fans not having the Undertaker anymore, mind you. In my opinion, it's a matter of time until Dean Ambrose is the next CM Punk of the company and is holding the World Championship, or better yet, the WWE Championship. Finally, ending the night was Triple H versus Michael what was his name? Curtis Axel. Triple H gets woozy. The doctors were telling him before the match, you shouldn't do this, you shouldn't do this. He gets woozy. He can't barely stand. He's all, like, concussed or whatever. You know, they wouldn't let Ziggler wrestle with a real concussion, but they say, Triple H threatens to fire you. Go ahead, sir. Go ahead. It's okay. Your brain can fall out of your ears. I'd like to keep my job, sir. Feel free. So, we're gonna have to see where that storyline progresses with Triple H pouring water on himself and being loopy, and he doesn't know what's going on, and he looked all goofy and all that kind of stuff, which, and the Academy Award for Best Actor goes to. So that's your wrap-up for all the wrestling that happened. I want to tell everyone, send in your Lingus Mafia pictures. It's pretty much you just going like this in front of different landmarks that are popular or wherever you're at. Bring them in, send them to us, Twitter, whatever, at Wrestlingus Show, and we will put them on the show. This week we decided really not to because we're doing this new format, or I'm doing this format because someone's in Las Vegas. So next week, the show will be back to normal. It'll be our last one before the new year of Lingus starts. So remember, send in those Lingus Mafia pictures, keep watching, and if you like this, hit the fucking like button, for God's sake. We get like 3 likes, but then we'll get like 200 views. Thanks. And those are those people that watch the Meat Twitcher and bounce out. So nonetheless, remember, when I got my Fausty Walnuts with me, together, we're assholes.